blessed coal at the Tin Palace. Granada falling at my feet, a Mayan princeling in the service of his conquerors, or the buried time between time, before I was young, when I saw my life to come, what it held in store, and decided I would live. Whoever I was in other lives, it doesn't matter to me now, as it does to Nat in the kitchen, placing layer on layer of paper-thin dough to make his spinach pies, that he was once a woman and, way back, an apprentice to a scribe sanding down stones. Or to Jim closing down the bar, that as a Nez Perce, he watched his people dying in the Montana snow, and that he was in tears. He says his name was Looking Glass, that he knows where he was born and where he's buried. Says he stood and said a prayer before his own grave. Largo. Maybe in the end, it's not the poet who wins, but the one who wanted to be a poet, because the will is not a beacon, but a match struck in the wind. And all we teach each other, or are taught, begins and ends as soon as it is thought. And every passion leads us from a known thing back into a deep unknown. The Vedas is now revealed to thee. Monsters are born in the dark and come to light. They exist to show you the shape of your fear, which you begin to see is the door to your heart that you have located in despair, but enter in sadness, a wave that carries you away from old wounds. From Divine Madness. The dead will not forgive those who fail to mark their passing or bury their remains. The dead will not forgive those who pass through their rooms in silence, noting blue squill in April on the lawns of their abandoned houses. Nothing is worse than their anger, not the curse of a brother, indifference of a daughter. The dead will not forgive those who abandon their children, the sadness of a son riding his bike through the autumnal streets of a paper mill town, white smoke billowing from stacks along the river where his father once worked the line. The Upanishads say, the Upanishads say, at the moment of death, our breath breaks up into particles of light, and gathering all that we are, descends into the heart, where it illuminates what had been in the dark, until trailing light and life, we are sucked into a wheeling hub of air and sun, beyond a drum-like rift in the moon, to a place free of snow. If I could take with me those I love, my broad-cheeked wife, our daughter whose chin fits my palm, into God's body through a hole in my heart. I'd wrap them both in particles of breath, funnel up to a place without grief and snow, as much of them as shared my time before I fell, or falling, rose. I would take those I love with me, yet leave them to compose their lives the way I tried as a child by an act of concentration to make a hole in time, through which the man I would become might reach back to touch his father's son. From Divine Madness. I, who have spoken the world, find myself with no one to talk to. I, who have loved the particulars of various landscapes, find myself at home in no place. History vanishes. All around me, children are taught the dead have nothing to tell them. Even as the dead whisper eternal secrets into the nautilus of their ears.